Good morning. Well, I've got a heat pump with a scroll compressor that I think is locked up. I'm going to take you along for the diagnosis. I don't know if I can fix it. We'll see. It may respond to a hard start kit, so let's get cracking. Well, the first sign that something was wrong was that the fan kicks in normally when it's calling for air conditioning, but a moment later when the compressor goes to start, all I get is a hum lasting for a second or so and then it stops. And if I wait, about a minute later it hums again for about a second or so and then stops. Before we get too far into this, let me show you some details about this compressor. Here's the model number, and most of them have a number at the end of the model number. This number is 60,000, and that refers to the BTUs, how much the system can put out. It turns out there are 12,000 BTUs for every ton, and so if you look at how the size of the system is quantified, this is a, you know, 5 times 12 is 5-ton system. Now the numbers down here, the locked rotor amperage, LRA, is 169 amps, so it's absolutely enormous. You get this enormous burst of current when the rotor is locked. And this RLA, this is the rated load amperage of 28 amps. Now that's a bit of a mathematical calculation. It's about 2/3, as I recall, of the maximum load current, which has to do with how much current it has to be fused for. But just remember that how much current a motor draws will depend all about how much work it has to do, and that'll depend on ambient conditions, temperature, pressures, and so forth. And so you can't read too much into these numbers. So here's the other side of this metal housing. This is an excellent wiring diagram. It's easy to read. Power comes in here to the contactor, and from the contactor power goes to the hermetically sealed compressor motor here and the fan motor. And this is the dual split capacitor right here. Now there's some optional accessories, and one of them is a 5-to-1 relay. This is a what they call a potential relay right here. And I've had a look, there is no start capacitor and no potential relay on this system. And so one of the things that's going through my mind is whether or not it might benefit from the addition of a potential relay and start capacitor based on the data for this particular compressor. So the first thing I did is I removed the cutout on the wall for safety. And to verify that there's no power coming in, I follow the incoming wires to the contactor and I just measure voltage here at these two wires. And I got 0 volts there. From the contactor, power goes to the dual run capacitor, then to the motors. This is the board. And if you look closely here, we still have some lights on. I think those lights are being backfed by the battery voltage in the thermostat, but there could still be 110 volt power still in this system, so you still need to be very careful. So the first major clue comes from the board. You can see power is on, and I've got this alert flashing light here. And if you count the flashes, I've got 4 yellow flashes. Now when I go to the legend beside the wiring diagram, I find that it's flashing up a locked rotor, so it's evidently cutting out because of excessive amperage. Let's try and verify that. A convenient place to start is a split run capacitor. I'm going to take off the wires, I'm going to check the capacitance of this capacitor, and I'm going to ohm out the windings of the motor at the same time from the same place. So before you start, you always ground out the capacitor because these can carry a nasty charge. So I just ground out all the sides, make sure there's no charge, and then take these ends off. And make sure you record what it was like beforehand, because the last thing you want to do is to have it messed up. So before taking these off, be damn sure that you know which way they go on, because the last thing you want to have happen is to put it on backwards. A tech could take hours trying to figure out what you did wrong. Okay, from my wiring diagram, I know this is common. This is to the fan, and the back one is to the compressor. And so now I'm going to check the capacitance. So we'll start with the fan first. The fan is 7.38 microfarads. Now let's do the compressor. 38.5 microfarads. So if you look at the data, the compressor is too low. The compressor should be 80 microfarads. So the capacitor has clearly failed, but we don't know why it's failed. It could have failed because the compressor was bad, or it could have damaged the compressor because it's failed. So we need to keep pursuing things. All right, now I'm going to ohm out my compressor windings. Now to do this, I need to zero my ohmmeter because it needs to be fairly accurate. And so I'm going to press this REL button there, and that accounts for any resistance in the lines. Now the red wire right here goes to the start winding. Clip that on there. And then the black wire goes here to the common. And I get 0.6 ohms. Now let's do the run windings, same thing. Yellow wire goes to there, and then common here. And I get 0.5 ohms. And so the two between each other should be 1.1 ohms because they should add together. And what do we have here? Hold that. 1.0, 1.1. So that's pretty much all normal. Now we don't want to know if it's shorted to ground. You can do it with all three of them and just pick any part that might be grounded and you should be fine. And I've done that with all three wires. So it's not shorted to ground, and the windings seem to all have resistance. So I've proven the resistance is pretty good. And so again, this points to a problem with the run capacitor. And so before getting too complicated with a hard stite, I'm gonna just swap in a new run capacitor and see if that's a problem. Now I've turned off the power again, and I'm gonna short out the capacitor just so I don't get a nasty shock. And then we'll take it off. Out with the old. Okay, well, let's see if it's just the run capacitor. I didn't expect that, honestly, but boy, that would be great, wouldn't it? So I've got the power back on. Now I'm gonna cycle the compressor and see what happens. Okay, my pipes are cold. So at that point, I took the batteries out of the thermostat and I cycled all the breakers, including the indoor breaker, and that trouble code is gone. And it stayed gone for the last week. And as far as I can tell, the heating and the cooling is entirely back to normal. But I think it'd be safe to say that this system is still at high risk for recurrence in the coming months. And so it raises the question as to whether we can do anything now to reduce its risk of recurrence. Okay, so now I'm left with a little bit of a dilemma because when I was working this up, I had already made the diagnosis that I thought I was going to need a hard start kit. And so I went to the Copeland dealer and I bought the individual components of a hard start kit. This is the potential relay here. It goes up that way. And this is the capacitor. Now for the capacitor, I chose a 300 microfarad capacitor capable of 330 volts. And I got that from this document in Emerson Engineering, where in the back page, they describe using that style of capacitor for a scroll compressor. But scroll compressors as a group don't tend to require start capacitors very often because they have fairly low starting torque. You see, the way they're designed, after the unit shuts down, within moments, the pressures are equalized on the two sides. And that's just because of the way it's designed. And so with low starting torque, the compressor shouldn't need extra start capacitance. On the other side, we've got a compressor that's upward of 18 years old. It's already had sub problems, and so part of me is saying, let's just go ahead and put this hard start kit in. I'd like to know what others think about this. Are there any dangers to putting a hard start kit into a scroll compressor? Say, if you got this far, I appreciate you coming along. I'd be particularly interested in any insight you might have. Thanks for watching.